Hey guys, welcome to another tutorial, and in this tutorial, we're not going to go into a long intro, so let's go ahead and dive in. We're going to be creating a very simple and basic traffic light inside of Blender. So, first things first, I'm going to pull in a reference image by hitting N, and we're going to scroll down on the sidebar to background images, hit a check on background images, and make sure you select add image, and then we're going to open, and I'm going to navigate to the image that I want to use as my reference image. So now we go to orthographic view by hitting number pad 5, and then we can go to front view, right view, whichever view, and this is going to give us a basic view of the traffic light. So I'm not going to be following this image too closely. I do have it pulled up here on Google Chrome. So let me collapse that to the side. And then pull this over right here like this. So we actually have two different images. If I need to rotate the view, I can still refer to it right here. So let's go ahead and get into this. We're going to start off with the basic default cube model, a base shape, and then we're going to add a subdivision surface to make it smoother. So first things, I want to scale this down the Z-axis by hitting S and Z. Some people say Z. I guess I've heard this like a Canadian or like a British way to say it. I just say Z. And then we're going to scale on the y-axis and then scale up on the x-axis. So hit SX. I'm going to view it from the top view and then hit S and Z. Just basically tweaking it to make sure that it's the perfect shape. So, I mean, we're not going to go for absolute perfection. I want to make this tutorial quick, so we're going to go with that. So hit Tab to go to Edit Mode. Press Control Tab on your keyboard and select Face. And now select this bottom face, and we're going to basically narrow this down. Let me show you the effect we're going for. So hit S and Y, and it's going to give us this effect right here. And actually, we can grab this on the Z-axis and grab it up a little bit, and S, Y. So we're going for that effect kind of like this right here. We want it to be, you know, thin on the backside, but wider on the top side where the lights are actually going to be. So now, it looks horrible. It looks nothing like a traffic light. It just looks like a random block. So we're going to go over here to our wrench icon on the right, add modifier subdivision surface, and we're going to go probably around 3. And now it looks even less like a traffic light. So let's go ahead and add some loop cuts to tighten this up. So go and head back to edit mode. We're going to hit Control R on the keyboard. Okay. Oop. That's not what I did last time, actually. So I'm already slipping up. So let's start again. We're going to do one right here in the middle. Drag this to the end. Try it again. We're going to do it again. Drag it to this end. And then we're going to drag one to the top. And we don't want to do any down here because, as you can see, if we do one and we drag it down here at the bottom, it's not really going to be smoothed off. The edges are going to be too tight down there. Instead, no! So in that case, if I hit Control-Z, it undoes all that. So hit Shift-Control-Z. And what you're going to have to do is go back to edit mode. Just select these edges right here that we don't want them here because it makes the edge too tight. Just hit X and dissolve the edge, and it will just collapse it. Okay, so this is going to be the base mesh. I just feel like my brain is falling apart, but I'm trying to keep moving. This is going to be the base of our traffic light, though, right here. It's kind of a mess, but it's going to work for now. So we're going to go to top view. Now, if you look closely, it's kind of hard to see it, but if you look closely on the traffic light, you can see that we have three in a row, almost cubular shapes that are sticking off of this base piece that we just modeled here. We have three of these very flat, cubish things that are on top of the shape. So, to add those, what we're going to do is go to Shift A, simply add a cube. We're going to scale this down. I want to scale it down about as wide as this is, so hit S and scale it up just a little bit more. And then we can grab this and pull it up by hitting, or actually let's just pull this arrow and then scale this on the Z-axis by hitting SZ. And we're going to make it about that thin. And then we're going to grab it on the Z-axis to touch this, just like that. Now we're going to grab it to this end right here. And don't worry if the edge sticks over this edge a little bit. We're going to add a subdivision surface and fix that up. So now the next thing that I want to do is add an array modifier because, as you see, there's going to be three in a row. We want them to look exactly the same. Rather than add three of these separately and model each of them separately, we're just going to save some time by adding an array. You're going to duplicate the same object that we modeled multiple times. So to do that, we're going to go over here to our wrench icon, add modifier, and hit array. And we do want it on the x-axis, but I want it on the other direction, so add. Instead of positive, make that a negative by putting a minus in front of it. And now it's doing it in the opposite direction, and I do want a little bit of a gap between these. So maybe if we go like negative 1.1 or even smaller, 1.03 or something, 1.02. We might even go with just 1.01. Yeah, we'll just go with 1.01, I guess. We're just going to be super specific, 1.015. And then go to count and hit that little arrow to add a third one. Now, obviously, this isn't long enough anymore to fit all three of these, so go to number pad 1 for side view. It's really simple. Just hit tab. Go to wireframe view real quick. And I'm going to go to vertices mode right down here. And just hit B to box select these vertices. Grab them on the x-axis by hitting GX. And just drag them until it lines up with the third one right here. So it looks like a mess still. But so this is going to start taking shape in a little bit. So we're going to go right here and add a subdivision surface to this. So go to modifier, subdivision surface. And, we could go to 3 on this one too. It looks horrible all over again, so we're going to tighten some edges by hitting tab to go to edit mode. Add a loop cut right here in the middle. Drag that up. Loop cut right down here in the middle. Drag it down to the bottom. And then add one right here. Drag it up this direction. And I'm going to go to top view to just try to pull it up to around the same tightness as this is. So we're going to go right around there. And then we're going to add one right here and tighten it up to about that point. And I don't want to spend too much time tweaking that, but I think that'll work right there. And this is what it looks like so far. It looks nothing like a traffic light still. So now what we're going to do is, let me hide these real quick. So if you look at this reference image, you see that we have almost what looks like these latch pieces or something. Now, when I actually created the model itself, I just took a very sloppy approach to modeling that. Based on some other reference images, it's not going to look like the approach I took. It doesn't really look like it in this image, but I saw some other images that kind of looked like the approach I took. So I'm going to show you what I did. So hit Alt-H to unhide these. So what I did was, I'm going to right-click on this to select it, Shift-S, snap cursor to selected, and I added a cube. I'm going to scale it way down, scale it down some more, grab it on the Z-axis, scale it down some more, and scale it up maybe a little bit, and I'm going to drag it. So we're going to have one right here near the top and the bottom of each of these cubular whatever they are, and then I'm going to scale it up a little bit more. I do want to scale it down on the Z-axis some. And then just scale it on the y-axis to about right there so that it sticks slightly over the edges. Grab it on the z-axis until it just barely pokes above the surface. Now go to tab to edit mode. And now we're going to add two loop cuts by hitting Control-R and moving it to this edge right here. To hit 2 on your keyboard, press Enter, and I'm just going to hit S and X to scale this and make that center part just a little bit wider. So now go to face mode by hitting Control Tab, selecting face. Select these two faces and extrude 0.1. Nope, not that much. Extrude 0.3 maybe. Whoa, what did I hit? Oh, well, first time was 0.1. Now I'm hitting 0.3. I mean 0.03. And that should work right there. So on this side, and do the same thing, extrude 0.03. And that's basically what I did. It doesn't really look like in the reference image, but it looks kind of like some of the images that I saw of different traffic lights. So I'm just going to go to tab edit mode, hit A once or twice to select everything, hit Shift D, hit X, and now it's going to duplicate this on the X axis. And we're going to drag it to right around here. And that is what we're going for. So we're going to add an array of these also. So there's two on each of these cubular objects. So click Add Modifier, hit Array. Again, we're going to make this negative. So it's the other direction. Oh my goodness, not negative 11. And then let's go negative 1.5. you know, just mess with some different values to go for the best look. And 1.4, maybe 1.415. You know, I don't really know. I'm just aiming for perfection here. So I'm going to count, hit that, and add a third one. And now we have it on all three of these. And I do, let me, yeah, let's go 1.1. Oop, 1.1. I'm just being super perfectionist right now. All right, we're going to go 1.413. That's very, very, very specific, but it just looks the best to me. So now we're going to go to modifiers, add a subdivision surface so that we can smooth these out. And we'll probably go with just two. We don't really need a three on this. Hit tab to go to edit mode. And we're going to add a loop cut, drag it up to the top, loop cut, drag it to the bottom. And then we're also going to add a loop cut. I'm trying to think how I want to do this. I need to center the camera view on these two right here. Okay. So, want to tighten up the edges better. That looks good just like that. So, I do want to add a loop cut right here. Add a loop cut right here. And that tightens up the edges pretty well. And then I'm going to add a loop cut right here and drag it down to this edge. And then we're just going to duplicate the process right here on the other side. So we're going to add a loop cut right here, drag it up. Loop cut right down here, drag it down. And then we're going to add a... We could add one right there. Add a loop cut in the center right here and drag it down. Add a loop cut right here. Add a loop cut right here. So it's not quite so spherical right there. This is a lot of loop cuts. Probably more than we need, to be honest, but... I should have told you guys at the beginning of the video, I'm not a pro 3D modeler, so I don't exactly know what's up, the best way to do things. But anyway, that's going to work right there. And we have all of those right across the surface, rendered view. And we're starting to get kind of a little bit of a shape. So obviously, let me drag all this aside so I can see the reference image. And then, obviously, the next step is going to be to add the little round cylinders themselves. So we're going to have a lot of fun with this. That's probably going to be about the funnest part of the tutorial. So let's go ahead and dive into that. And to do that, I'm just going to snap the cursor to select it so it's somewhere near where we need it to be. Shift A, we're going to add a mesh, a circle. The default 32 vertices will work just great. And we're going to grab this. Actually, I want it right below the surface. So we're going to go to top view by hitting number pad 7. Hit Z to go to wireframe view. I'm doing all these shortcuts faster than I'm saying them. So we're going to drag it right here to the center of this first cube. Scale it down to about just like that. And now hit tab to go to edit mode. Make sure you're in vertices mode. And then we'll be ready to get started. So, try to remember exactly how I did this. What I'm going to do is hit extrude, grab on the, or better yet, extrude Z. And we're going to extrude it to about here. We're going to extrude, scale that down a little bit. And let me refer back to the reference image a little bit. This was not, there was another one I was looking, another reference image I was actually looking at more than this one, but let's see. We're just going to go like that, and then we're just going to extrude this on the z-axis and grab it on the z-axis pretty far, because these pieces actually stick out quite a bit. If you look, they actually stick out quite a bit. And then you notice it's really dark like this. That's because the normals are not in the right direction. So to fix that, just go to tab, edit mode, hit A to select everything, and just hit control N on the keyboard, and voila, it's perfect. So now, of course, if you look at the reference image, you see that it's not a perfect sphere. There's a part cut out of it right here. So to do that, it's really easy. Just go to tab and go to top view. And, oh, maybe not top view, but we're going to select this face right, I mean, this vertice right here. And then we're going to select the other two in each direction to the side. And just hit X to delete the vertices. And that should give us the look we're going for. Now, obviously, it's super, super thin, way more thin than an actual piece would be in a real traffic light. So what we're going to do is go to modifiers, add a solidify modifier right down here, and it's going to make it thicker and also add faces on the inside. And so what I did, I think when I first modeled it, was add a thickness of 0.025, and then I'm going to collapse that. And then we're going to add a subdivision surface. Of course, we're going to go for about a value of 2 probably. We can also smooth this now, and then we can go to tab, edit mode, add a loop cut across the center, and just drag it up so that it's not, so it's more of a tight curve. And then we're going to also add one, drag it down toward the bottom to tighten that edge. Add one over here, pull it in to tighten the edge, and then add one right here, drag it in. And also, if you ever find that you're rotating around, like, you're rotating around a weird point in the 3D view and you want to rotate around whatever you're modeling, just select it and hit right by your number keys, hit it's a period, and it says delete on it, hit that key, and it will automatically center your rotation view around it. Makes it a lot easier. And then, I think that'll work right there, actually. So we're going to select this, and of course, just like before, add an array modifier. And we're going to put this on the negative axis. We're going to go to top view, and we're just going to start tweaking some different values. 1.23 maybe, add a third one. And then the third one's not perfectly lined up, so we're going to go for more 1.22, 1.25. Yeah, we'll go for 1.25. So now, actually, it somewhat resembles an actual traffic light. I don't like how tall that is, though. So I'm just going to go to wireframe view, box select these, and just grab them down. And now if we go to rendered view by hitting Shift-Z, the lighting is very bad, but you know, it kind of looks like an actual traffic light. So now we want to add the lights inside of the cylinders. So to do that, I want to center the view exactly right in the middle here. So when we select it, the origin is right in the middle of the mesh, so hit, just right-click on it and hit Shift-S, cursor to selected. I feel like everything I'm saying, I'm just giving a horrible explanation, but hopefully you guys can kind of see what I'm doing. I'm not very good at explaining things. That's the downside of me trying to teach people, but hopefully you can kind of see what I'm doing. So we're going to hit Shift-A. Oh, wrong one. I hit Control-A. Shift-A, add a UV sphere, and that's just a little bit too big. So we're going to scale that down. And we're going to scale it down to perfectly fit inside of this. But we want it to fit very, very, very snugly. We might actually be able to scale it up a little bit more. Yeah, we're going to go for that. And then what I want to do is, first of all, hit Shift-H on the keyboard. Shift-H. And it's going to hide everything but the sphere. And what we want to do, we only need the top part of this. Because the bottom part you're not going to see. So we can actually delete the bottom part of the sphere. So hit number pad 1 to go to the side view, tab to go to edit view, and hit A to deselect everything, hit Z to go to wireframe view, and we're actually going to select, I'm going to select probably all these faces here and just hit X, delete vertices. And that was using the keyboard shortcut B for box select. And I'll just hit A to select everything and hit S and Z to make it flatter. And I think that works. So hit Alt-H to hide everything. And grab this and just drag it down until you can't see the bottom anymore. And that should kind of work. I'm actually going to scale this up on the Z-axis a little bit more. Grab it up a little bit more on the Z-axis. And we can hit Smooth and add a subdivision surface just to make it all pearly. Set the view and render values to 1. Gonna make it look all pearly. What was that? So now we're going to add an array modifier for this as well. And what was the value we had for this? It was 1.225, so negative 1.225. And for some reason, I think because this scale is slightly different, so that value was not perfect. So we're going to increase it to about 1.4 is a little bit too much. We're going to go 1.32, 1.31. 1.305. Actually, I think 1.308 should do the job. So now, so I can see what this looks like in render view. I'm going to go to our little world icon right here and add some ambient inclusion. That's gonna, just going to add like some environment lighting like this. And you see we got like a nice little traffic light going on. I'm not quite as pleased as when I first modeled it, but so far it's not half bad. So I'm going to try to start doing the final parts of this tutorial because it's already been about 20 minutes. Wow. So let's go ahead and wrap this up. Now, one thing I did do when I originally modeled it, and you see we have a few problems here, but I'm not going to mess with those too much because time's running short. One thing I did do in the original model was add kind of like some, like if you look at this one right down here, you see we have like some little pieces right down here. Like it looks like some bolts, and then there's like a little cylindrical piece right there where it connects to the traffic whatever thingamajig. So what we're going to do, I actually did a different way. I'm going to do it a different way this time. I'm going to go to face select and select these two bottom faces. And just hit extrude, right click, scale that down. This is number pad 3. Hit control number pad 3 to go to the left view. And just grab this down and bounce it a little bit. And now we can extrude this in. And then, oh, actually extrude the inward and then hit inset, I believe it is. Yes, inset. I on the keyboard to inset that and it'll make it a lot sharper. So this gives us this nice little look right here. And then I'm going to Shift S, snap cursor to selected, and we're going to hit Shift A, add a circle. So many shortcuts and stuff to add. So we're going to rotate on Y, say RY 90 to rotate on this circle on the Y axis 90 degrees, and just scale this down. And I'm going to hit Control Number Pad 3 again. And I'm just going to scale it down a little bit more and just center it in the middle of this area. And now hit Tab, go to Vertex Select. And just hit extrude, right click, and just scale this extrusion down. And now hit A twice to select everything and just extrude it on the X axis like this. And now just hit tab and just drag this right over here. And of course, we can add a subdivision surface right here. About 2 and smooth it. And then we're going to add a loop cut, drag it right here, a loop cut, drag it to the other side, and then we're going to add a loop cut right here to tighten these edges, loop cut right here, and then we're going to add a loop cut right here also to tighten that up. So it gives us a nice, smooth, whatever that would be called. And then, like in the reference image, if you'd like, you can add some bolts. They look pretty basic. Looks like there's about 4 of them. And that's going to be very simple. Just hit Shift A, add a circle, rotate RY 90, scale that way down. And you can just, for example, just like grab them right here and then hit Tab and just fill that. And you can hit the little dot button by the number pad keys to center the view on this and then just extrude this on the X axis and then select everything and just hit Control N so it's not so dark. Like that. And then you can just do that to add some various bolts and screws around the object. Obviously, I'm not going to spend too much time messing with that. That is the modeling process that I use. As you can tell, it's very scrappy. I'm not very good at this. I'm still kind of a noob when it comes to 3D modeling. But I want to show you guys what I know. So we're going to create some quick cycled render materials. So we're going to go to click up here and select cycles render. And we're going to start creating some materials. So go right up here to this little icon, click on that, and select compositing. And we're going to go to the materials view, and just hit this little icon here, and select this material, and just click to rename it. Golden. And now click over here to use nodes, and we're going to create a material. We're going to drag this aside, and we're going to create kind of like a shiny material, but we don't want it to be super shiny. And of course, like in the pictures, it's going to be a nice orangish, goldish, shiny material. So hit Shift A, go to shader. We're going to add a mixed shader. And we're going to click right over there, Shift A, shader. And then we're going to add a glossy shader. So it's going to be part glossy, part diffuse. Diffuse is just kind of just a solid color. So we want it to be mostly shiny. So we're probably going to go about 0.65. It's going to be about 65% shiny. If we go here to Shift Z. you could kind of see the result. Even though we've, this, so far, this piece right here is the only part that's actually got the material. So what we're going to do is to, for the color, we're going to hit Shift A, go to search and just add, type in RGB, RGB, and add one right here, and plug in the color node right here into the color nodes of both of these, and that way when we change the color of this, it's going to change the color for both of these. Otherwise, we would have had to change the colors, change it on one of these, and then change it on the other. So, let's see. So we want to go for, what do we want to go for? I had the hardest time getting the perfect color on the last time I modeled this, and even then it was not perfect. Obviously, I don't want to take all day picking the perfect shade, but you know what? Let's go with that right there. It looks horrible, but it looks good enough, I guess. So now select our piece right here. Select our golden material. Select our little notch things here. Select the golden material, and now everything should be golden, except for this right here. So we are going to go ahead and add the materials to our piece right here. So what I have to do is I have to go ahead and apply the array modifier. Otherwise, if I add the material to this, suppose I want to make this. Oh, yeah, the top, one on the top is red. I was forgetting. I haven't started driving yet, so I don't remember all this stuff. But the one on the top is red. If I make that one red with the array modifier applied, these two are going to be red, too. And there's, I've never seen a traffic light with all three of the lights red. So, and I don't want to see one that looks like that either. So that each one of these can have a different color, go ahead and go to the wrench icon here and just apply the array modifier. And that way, each of these is now a separate mesh. So we're going to hit select this top one right here. But first of all, go right here to our materials panel and just add a new material. This is going to be red. Add a new material also. This one's going to be green. Not green. Green. And then add another one. This one's going to be yeller. Okay, so select the one on the top. Right-click on it and hit L. And then select red. Hit assign. This top one's going to be red. And I think the one in the middle is yellow. So select yellow and assign. And then I think the one on the bottom is green. So select that and click assign. And that way, when we create the materials, this one's going to be red. This one's going to be yellow. And this one's going to be green. I think. So select this one on the top. Hit L. And now we're going to select the red material, and we're going to create it. So the material for this is extremely, extremely easy. Just select the diffuse, hit X to delete it, Shift A, add a shader, emission, just plug it in. I wasn't able to go for the cool, kind of almost computer screen type of effect. I just added a simple, boring red color like this because I didn't really know how to add that other effect. But if you hit Shift Z to view rendered, I mean, it looks okay, I guess. And then this one down here, you are supposed to be, this is supposed to be green. There we go. So assign that. And then also what I want to do is add another material and just name this black, and I'll show you what that one's for. So this is just going to be diffused. It's going to be almost pure black, just like dark, dark gray. And I'm going to take these two and assign it to them. That way, one of them is going to be shining, and the other two are going to be black while only one of them is shining. And then when it switches, this one up here is going to be black. This one's going to be yellow or whatever it is. And then, yeah, so you can go ahead and select the other materials, and you can add a shader, emission, plug it in, go for a green, why not? And then you can do that to each of them. So anyway, hit tab, and with more or less, we're done with our model. We've got basic, horrible material set up. I've just been trying to rush this because the video is already a half an hour. But that's kind of the workflow I had when creating this traffic light. And this is bugging me. So hit Control Number Pad 3 and just hit 5 for number for the orthographic view and just Shift DY. It's just bugging me. I'm just going to add one right here. So it looks a little more symmetrical, so it doesn't bug me as much. And of course, these need to have the golden material. Boomp. 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 There we go. I don't think boomp is the sound of when something gets the golden material, but it works here. So I'm going to hit Shift A, add a mesh, a plane, and just drag that down. Just scale that way, way up. We're going to select the light right here, hit Use Nodes. We're going to give an emission value of like 1500. That is very bright, but it will work for this. We're going to drag it like, I don't know, like over the center. Just grab it up on the Z-axis a little bit. And ambient occlusion, we could probably turn that off. And depends on what you want to go for. So we're going to give it a factor of like 0.1, some slight environment lighting. And now if we go to camera view, hit M, go to, scroll down here where it says lock camera view, and that way when you use your middle mouse button, you can now rotate your camera view around the screen. So now you can hit F12 and render, and we have a great traffic light for you to use in your animations, your video games, or whatever it is that you need. So anyway, guys, thank you for watching this video. More great content coming soon, and you have a great day.